Hello, and welcome to the course on digital and web analytics from eCdemy. My name is Michael Seaton, and I've been involved in the digital space for well over 25 years. I've worked at and ran digital at some of Canada's largest and most successful brands, including the financial services industry, the government sector, and the private sector as well. I've worked on the agency and consulting side, and I have been an instructor both for the Canadian Marketing Association, and currently I'm an instructor at the University of Toronto, where I teach digital marketing and analytics. In this course, what you are going to take away is not just the how to use Google Analytics, but we're going to begin and build what not many other courses on the planet can achieve, which is an understanding of the business context behind all that you will learn in the analytics world. Businesses today have adapted and evolved within the digital world. Digital has become a business priority, and our marketing and our communications are leading the charge in digital channels to reach consumers. Our reliance on these channels has become so important now that measurement is going alongside every step we take in this world to reach the right customers at the right time, in the right place, with the right offer. The opportunity that we have in front of us with a course like this is to get in on the ground floor, not just to understand web analytics and Google Analytics, but understand the business context in which they exist. Today's customer journey is complex. It is no longer a world of traditional broadcast advertising where TV, radio, and print hit us. It is truly a world where we interact and have a multitude of different choices as an audience in the digital world. We're going to review all of the important facets that fit into the world of business intelligence and break down how digital and web analytics fit into the world of business intelligence gathering. We're going to look at the importance of a measurement plan and the discipline of setting up a process that will lead to the ultimate goal of measuring your success in the digital space. But without a plan, we go into every situation in an ad hoc manner. So we teach that background and that discipline so you can rely on it as you move forward successfully in this space. We break down concepts like macro conversions versus micro conversions within the Google Analytics platform so that your setup and your usage and your measurement of results are accurate and reflect truly what your company values from interactions on your digital and web properties. We're going to look at attribution and the different attribution models that have to make sense to marketers in terms of the budgets that they hold and the ROI they are trying to drive back to their companies. We're going to give you an exclusive look at two case study companies that we have created specifically for the course to showcase how we can not just build on the analytics platform, but apply the importance of analytics and finding those key insights by using these example companies and going through scenarios that may reflect what you will face in the real world. We're going to look at how this data comes together on the platform, how the data is collected in terms of its raw hits, how it gets filtered and set into categories, and then how it ends up in the reports that you can use. So we provide that background so you have all of the prerequisites to understand what goes on before you dive into the reporting layer. We're going to walk through best practices that Google points out to set up our accounts properly, structure them in the right way so that we can get the most value out of our analytics usage and efforts. Part of the course breaks out the content in ways that no other course will, which are callout boxes and mini maps, so that we can speak to all of the user controls and features within the platform specific to what your task would be at any given time. These mini maps are intended to form a foundation with callouts that provide you all the necessary details to maximize your use of the reporting interface. We break down what's involved in all the reports and give you a good context and background for which reports to use when. In the example of an audience report, this is an in-depth look at your users, their characteristics, and their reporting behaviors where we can drive more deep understanding of how our audience is getting to our site, who they are, where they're located, and the devices and technology platforms that they're using to access our website or our mobile platforms. We're going to look at the type of segments that we can drill into and find out great information from. There's a variety of segments that we can identify and we can isolate. These segments become subsets of information that we will describe in detail and paint a clear picture for you on how segments can be purposeful and powerful in terms of what you need to drive revenue, understanding, and insights from your business. We're going to look at the numerous ways that you can segment your data within Google Analytics, where to go, how to break it down, and the choices that you can make about the channels, behaviors, or audience characteristics that you need to know. We'll look at how to apply segmentation criteria, where to go, and how to do it properly. And we're going to introduce the concept of goal conversion and tracking to you. Now, goals are the most important thing that you will have to measure on your site because they're the indicators of your success. These are conversions that are ultimately the things that we want customers and prospects to do on our site to convert to the areas we hope they will. The type of conversions you'll measure will depend on your unique situation, and we describe various scenarios that you may want to apply to your unique situation or company or scenario. Typically, we want to measure our sales or downloads, form submissions, or other behaviors that actually count for something so we can call them a goal. We're going to look at how we take our goal values further by applying a monetary assignment to them. In other words, how much can we count on this goal contributing to our top line or bottom line? Each company has its own unique situations for tracking and assigning value. And from a management perspective, we're going to bring you that information and showcase to you how we can drive end business user value by understanding not just what we can measure, but enlightened measurement and adding value to those key points that others who are not familiar with the Google Analytics platform will look to you to provide. We're going to look at the integration of non-website data into the Google Analytics platform to give you a more holistic view of your interactions with customers and prospects, both online and offline, by citing the Universal Analytics platform that has now been updated to be called the 360-degree platform from Google, but we'll overview that for you as well. One of the most important parts of analytics is understanding what's going on with our e-commerce and getting access to our reports in analytics. We're going to review where to find that information, how to set it up properly, and some of the terms that you'll need to know, like revenue, average order value, unique purchases, and other elements that will feed into your knowledge base around e-commerce reporting and success. We're going to look at how to integrate other data systems and provide an overview of how to import data from a CRM system or a content management backend system or a commerce platform or other ways that we can integrate data into Google Analytics to benefit a holistic view of the customer. And we will also look into the world of testing and learning using our digital assets. The role of testing is to better inform our decision making, and we understand as companies and as web analytics practitioners that the value of testing is paramount in determining not just what we think is best, but what our customers are responding to best. So in this world of A/B testing or multivariate testing, we will go through and explain not only its importance, but how you can apply it within Google Analytics for your efforts. We will walk you through a little bit of the scientific method. That is the underpinning of success for any testing and learning. We will indicate how you can drive hypotheses and then take those into experimentation, observation, and then extrapolate your learnings to the organization and to your future initiatives. We do this all and drive home the key message throughout the course of continuous improvement. Continuous improvement is what all companies seek to do in all of their efforts, but what we can do is use the immediacy, relevancy, and accuracy of the data we find in Google Analytics to use that in an ongoing, proactive capacity to improve our underlying business results. And that's what this course will offer you, both a hands-on look under the hood at how Google Analytics works and how you can drive the maximum effectiveness from the platform in your efforts, but also create an umbrella effect to understand not just how Google Analytics works, but how it fits into today's ever-changing and evolving business world. And we hope that you will take the course and you will reap the learnings that we have both from a fundamental business understanding of Google Analytics and web analytics and digital analytics, as well as hands-on experience and practical knowledge with the platform itself. We hope to see you taking the course soon.